Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. We live in an age today where ignorance is the order of the day, and people have strayed so far from the basics of Islam that when you tell them things which are entrenched in the very roots of Islam, then people say, that's something new, that's something strange. Where do you come on with these sort of things? One such thing which is often brought about by people who have kufr in their heart is they ask the question, why do you hate the Shia? Why are you always going on about the Shia? Love and let love and all these other type of statements that they bring about. The reason why we hate the Shia is because primarily the Shia, they have a religion separate from Islam. Shia are not Muslim. And this is a very common misconception where people say Islam is Sunni and Shia, as though it's two sides of the same coin, the same thing, two just groups. There is no such thing. Shiaism is a religion. Islam is a religion. There's no Sunni and Shia Muslim. There's no such a thing as a Shia Muslim. It's like saying there's a Christian Muslim or a Hindu Muslim or a Jewish Muslim. Unless you're talking about the race, Jewish Muslim. But the thing is that you can't be a Christian Muslim or a Hindu Muslim or a Satanist Muslim. It don't work that way. So too can you not be a Shia Muslim. It's an oxymoron. So Shiaism is a religion and Islam is something entirely separate from them. The religion of Islam, we are the Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, which is where the term Sunni comes from. But Shiaism, it has nothing to do with Islam. Our aqidah, our very basic beliefs as entrenched as part of Islam, Imam At-Tahawi rahimahullah, he encapsulated it all in his kitab, which is accepted across the entire Muslim world for over 1,000 years. That kitab is known as Al-Aqidah At-Tahawiyyah. And within this kitab, he makes mention with regards to the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. He says, وَحُبُّهُمْ دِينٌ وَإِيمَانٌ وَإِحْسَانٌ. Loving the Sahaba radiallahu anhum is deen itself. It is iman and it is ihsan. All the goodness is in loving the sahaba radiallahu anhum. While on the flip side of the coin, وَبُغْضُهُمْ كُفْرٌ وَنِفَاقٌ وَطُغْيَانٌ. While hatred of the sahaba radiallahu anhum is kufr, it is hypocrisy, it is transgression. That's where the people who hate the sahaba radiallahu anhum. And Imam At-Tahawi rahimahullah, he goes further and he makes mention, وَنُبْغِضُ مَن يُبْغِضُهُمْ. And we hate those who hate the sahaba radiallahu anhum. But it doesn't just end it there. And he makes further mention that included amongst those whom we hate are those who speak about the sahaba radiallahu anhum in ways that is not suitable, in ways that is not good. So we only speak good about the sahaba radiallahu anhum. You have people and the Shia, and he'll come along and he'll say, but I don't curse them. But he holds a dislike. He don't really care for them in his heart. That alone is a sign that he is not from the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. There are multiple aspects of kufr of the Shia. The Shia, the reason why they are a religion, they have a different adhan. They have a different shahada. They have a different method of what they call salah. They have amongst them those who have a different Quran, different ajza, paras, which was eaten up by the goat, which is being kept by the hidden Mahdi who's crawling in a well somewhere. They have all. This is a fraction of the beliefs that the Shia hold. The Shia are not lovers of the Ahlul Bayt. The Shia are haters of the Ahlul Bayt. The Shia are homosexuals in that they try to make Hadhrat Ali radiallahu anhu gay like them. So they say Hadhrat Ali radiallahu anhu could do nothing. Hadhrat Fatima radiallahu anha scolded him. She, when Hadhrat Umar radiallahu anhu, wa na'udhu billahi min dhalik, in their concocted kufr beliefs, came in and kicked the door down of the house of Hadhrat Ali radiallahu anhu, kicked Hadhrat Fatima radiallahu anha and aborted the child there, and Hadhrat Ali radiallahu anhu hid inside the room. وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. When Asadullahi al-Ghalib is reduced to being a person who's cowering in a corner in another room while his wife is being kicked and his house attacked, his unborn child aborted and killed over there, and he do nothing. And you say this is a person who loves the Ahlul Bayt? Far removed are the Ahlul Bayt from the Shia kafir. The A'imma throughout the ages, whether it's Imam Malik, whether it's Imam Ahmad, Imam Ash-Shafi'i, Imam Abu Hanifa, throughout the ages, the ulama have been unanimous that the Rawafid, the Rafida Shia, they are kafir. And this is what we find around us today. The vast majority, Iran and all of their allies and all of them, they are all Ithna Ashara Shia, which are the Rawafid kafir. The other brands of Shias are the Alawis and the Boras and them, and they, some of them have such kufr that even the 12 is make takfir of them. So they are a great conglomeration of kufr and evil, and Islam is far removed from them. Now I made mention that وَنُبْغِضُ مَا يُبْغِضُهُمْ, we hate those who hate them. People today amongst the modernists, they come and they say, but Islam don't teach a person to hate. And I say this is due to having a total lack of understanding of the deen. Because not all hatred is bad, and in fact Islam does teach you to hate. Amongst the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there's a very famous one, and this hadith is reported by different muhaddithin. Some have extra wordings expanded on, but the one short version, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Afdalul a'mal," the best of deeds. This is not me or the next man saying it. This is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying it. And this hadith is reported by Imam Ahmad. It's reported by Imam Abu Dawud. Imam al-Tabarani rahimahullah has a similar version. Different muhaddithin also reports this hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, أَفْضَلُ الْأَعْمَالِ الْحُبُّ فِي اللَّهِ وَالْبُغْضُ فِي اللَّهِ. That the best of deeds is to love for the sake of Allah and to hate for the sake of Allah. Not to dislike people, but to hate, that's the word which is used, to hate for the sake of Allah. And another hadith goes further and it expands, and you give, to give for the sake of Allah, to withhold and prevent things for the sake of Allah. Different hadith all on the same topic. So Islam does speak about hating people when people are on evil. And the modernistic mindset is so corrupted in kufr that he cannot fathom this. But ask them, do you like terrorists? No, we hate terrorists. We hate terrorism. Do you like the drug addicts and drug peddlers? We say, no, we dislike them. We hate them. You were willing to say that for a drug dealer, but for the person who cursed the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, how can we hate them? That shows that there is deep kufr within your heart. And any person who holds such a belief has to compulsorily repent, return to Islam, and ask Allah to remove that evil from their heart, because that is not from the belief of the Muslims. So it is part of our deen throughout the ages, with this religion brought by Abdullah ibn Sabah, who made the Shia religion. Whenever Islam was attacked throughout the ages, it was through the Shia. When Baghdad was sold out by Ibn al-Alqami, it was a Shia kafir. When the Muslims, at any point in time in the world, it was always the Shia kuffar who were undermining Islam continuously from the very inception of the Shia religion. Shiaism is not Islam. They can wear their tires, they can pray on their stones, but they are from the people of Iblis. They are not from the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They are haters of the Ahlul Bayt, not lovers of the Ahlul Bayt. Islam is free of them and they are free of Islam. There are so many points that has kufr of the Shia that if a person understood even one, you'd understand these are not people of Islam. And the reason, we understand many people in the context of their personal lives. So if somebody comes along and swears your mother, you want to get all up in a huff and you want to fight, and that's norm. And of course, unless you're emasculated, then you such things don't come along your way. You say, no, swear her more, swear my parents more, I don't mind. Then you're not a man. But that is the way of a normal human being. Somebody insults your parents, you want to attack them. And Allah, no less, is the one who tells us, وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ, that the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam are the mothers of the believers. Allah tells us the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam are the mothers of the believers. So if you dislike Hadhrat Aisha radiallahu anha and you say she's not your mother, then obviously you have yourself thrown yourself out of Islam, because Allah said, mother of the believers, you say she's not my mother, then obviously you're not a believer, because you're not included in that ayah of the Quran. There are numerous ayat in the Quran which the ulama have used as a basis to show the kufr of the Shia, and this is merely one of them. So the Shia, they hate the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they hate the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, those people whom Allah said regarding them, radiallahu anhum wa radu'an, that Allah is pleased with them, and Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Allah. They are the people who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, La tasubbu ashabi, don't swear my sahaba. They are the people regarding whom Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah, Allah fi ashabi, la tattakhidhum gharadan min ba'di. Fear Allah with regards to my sahaba. Do not take them as a target of attack after me. Faman ahabbahum, fabi hubbi ahabbahum. Those who love them because he loves me. وَمَنْ أَبْغَضَهُمْ فَبِبُغْضِي أَبْغَضَهُمْ and those who hate them because he hate me. So this is how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, how the fuqaha, how the sahaba and everyone have understood Islam for 1400 years. We are not in need to reinvent the wheel and change Islam to suit the people who have a sympathetic line towards the Shia. Like the Christians are kuffar fi nari jahannam, so too are the Jews fi nari jahannam, and the Hindus are fi nari jahannam, and the Shia, and the Hadith rejectors, and the Qadianis, and all those people, they are fi nari jahannam as not being part of Islam. This is our belief as Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah. This is our belief that has been the same for 1400 years. It does not change, and it will not change until the end of time. Either they turn to Islam and become Muslim, or they will face the abode that is waiting for them. Like the Christian, oh, the only thing awaiting him at the end of the day is Jahannam. So too for the Jew, so too for the Shia and the Hadith rejector and every other kafir that is out there. Do not pander to the worms and the deviants and the kuffar and murtadeen and all these type of people. We hold firm to the deen brought to us by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, transmitted through the 124,000 sahaba radiallahu anhum to the a'immati mujtahideen, salaf and the khalaf, right down until it has reached us today. Islam is perfect and will never change. And those who seek to change Islam are the people who are free from Islam. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.